It's up to you, New York.
Okay, y'all, we are in New York City for the first time ever, which is so crazy, with my friend Cassidy, and it actually was so last minute. I was planning on going with one of my friends from college and her baby, but he got sick, so they had to cancel. So I literally called up Cassidy and was like, hey, you wanna go to New York in 5 days? And she pulled through and bought a ticket. We don't really have any plans besides eating our way through the city, maybe popping into a couple museums and just like thrifting and just sightseeing and stuff. And I just feel like that is just the ideal trip for me. Like, I am so freaking excited. I probably think that New York probably has the best food in the country. I've never even been here, but that's my impression.
Wow, those are high hopes.
We're staying here in Bowery, which is near like the Lower East Side. Hey,
show them the view.
No, let's show them the view. This is our view, guys. It's giving concrete jungle.
Hey. Let's hit the city.
That I got lavender matcha, and I was really unsure because I don't like anything floral. She said it tasted like Fruit Loops, and it does. It actually tastes like Fruit Loops. It's actually so good.
Is it good?
Oh my god.
That's good, right?
It's like garlic confit. So good with the herbs.
Very lemony and anchovy, but I love it. That is so good. If we weren't planning on eating our way around the rest of our trip, I would order 3 more of these and take them home.
No way.
Okay, this is what we're having for breakfast, lunch, and dinner.
We got the world famous banana pudding from Magnolia Bakery. Oh, should we just pop a squat real quick? Wow.
So bomb.
Are you kidding?
It's like not creamy. Pudding.
I don't really taste the banana. Where the hell is it?
There's banana slices in it.
Are there?
Yeah. You don't taste it? Does it taste cheesy? Like a cheesy texture.
It's kind of like a cheesy texture for sure.
Cream cheesy.
Very cheesecake vibes.
Cheesecakey.
Yeah.
Okay, let's try the
I'm missing the banana. Yes. Now we're trying the cookie butter banana pudding. Okay, if you get a piece of banana, yes, but there should be more banana because I don't like having a bite with no banana.
Really?
I didn't taste it.
But you said
it.
You don't like banana that much.
Yeah, you're right, I don't. But if I'm getting banana pudding, I expect a banana. New York, taste test.
Good morning, guys. Cassidy doing some work with this gorge view. And I'm gonna run down and get some coffee. I'm not even a coffee drinker. I just, you know, we're traveling and I need to go to the bathroom.
Engaged, and I'm the FaceTime, and we're
Hedwig. So we just finished at the Met, and now we are heading to 7th Street Burger, which apparently has really good smash burgers. And we're smash burger people, so we're really excited. We got spicy loaded beef fries.
Whoa.
Oh, holy shit. This is actually so much grease. Cheers. Cheers.
Oh, wow, so hot.
OTM.
Dinner time.
Perfect evening. We just got cookies from Levain Bakery.
Nah, it sounds like you're
and we just popped on the Love is Blind reunion. We haven't talked yet today. We leave tomorrow, which is so crazy. You know, it's my first time ever coming to like the East Coast and experiencing New York City. Obviously people say that it's very different, East Coast versus the West Coast. Genuinely, I just can't even like comprehend what it would be like to grow up in New York City. Like, it's so different. And I know it's a big city and big cities are different than what I'm used to anyway. But like, wow. We were walking through Chinatown today to walk the Brooklyn Bridge, and I think it was like around the time that school was let out, and there were all of these like groups of kids just like roaming the streets, and I just find that so crazy. I don't know why. And just like the way they were dressed and like the way they were talking, and like, it's just so different. It's so different. A lot of people's dream is to like live here. But like, I could not do it. I don't think I could live in any big city, to be quite honest, though. I'm just not a city girl. And that's fine. You know, everyone's different. But it's just, it's been so interesting. But the food has been so good. And I knew it would be. I knew it. You have the clip. I've just been enjoying that so much. We're going to go grab some food right after this. And then we'll probably call it a night. And if you couldn't tell by my stunning makeup today, Cassidy did my makeup. I haven't even told you guys that yet. But Cassidy is a mwah. Mwah. She did my makeup today. And freaking killed it, and I was feeling very pretty walking the streets of New York. So let's go get some food. That's what I'm talking about right now. Look at that. No flop in sight.
Hey everyone, place number 4.
getting pop-up bagels to start our last day.
Oh, I'm so excited.
Oh!
The butter. It looks fine.
It is cinnamon.
Mm-mm.
Like that smells sugar really good. Damn, that's crazy.
God.
Wow.
Okay guys, this is the end of the video. Thank you so much for watching if you made it this far. Directly after this ramen, I went to the airport and flew to Milan, and I will be in Italy for the next 3 months, so you guys should stay tuned for my upcoming videos. I wanted to give a quick shout out to the hotel that we stayed at. We stayed at Citizen M in Bowery. I felt like the price was pretty affordable by New York standards, but I did book our hotel 5 days in advance, so it could be because of limited availability. The hotel was clean, the people were so nice, and the rooftop view was absolutely stunning. I will say that the rooms are really narrow and small, but it has a king size bed and it's super comfortable. When we checked in, we told them it was our first time in New York and they gave us free drink tickets at the rooftop bar. And I just felt like the location was perfect. There are so many good food spots nearby. Soho is incredibly close. I would absolutely recommend.
Hi.
Hi.
Alla vodka.
Damn. What, I just don't think he was well on TikTok.
Really?
Yeah. I don't know. You're not on X TikTok.
Is that like shitting on exes for this song?
Yeah. Fuck my ex. It's literally like the chorus.